The Samsung Galaxy A32 here is one of the A-series smartphones announced before the A52 and the A72. I have videos on those smartphones also, you can check the channel for those. It comes in both a 5G and 4G LTE variant, which I have here. I'll run you guys through my hands-on review of the somewhat awesome offer from Samsung. And so without taking much of your time, yo guys, let's get started. As usual, unboxings first, and on opening the box for the first time reveals the envelope thingy with a jelly case and some paperwork. Next up is the smartphone itself, which I'm setting aside for now. Then further down are the USB-C connector, a 15-watt fast charger, and then the SIM ejection tool. Even though the design on the rear of the smartphone got me as excited as I was for the A52 and the A72, you definitely would notice from the front of the A32 here that it is a little brother in the lineup with this notch-styled front-facing camera, unlike the cutouts you get from the big brothers this year. Button placements are usual for Samsung, power button and volume rocker to the right, fingerprint sensor is an in-display type here, and you still have a 3.5mm jack port with USB-C, and the smartphone is actually made out of plastic, giving it this light weight. Design is generally impressive on the A32. The display is actually really impressive this time when compared to the A31 from last year. You are getting a 6.4 Super AMOLED panel at full HD in resolution with a 90Hz refresh rate. When it comes to the display on this smartphone under direct sunlight, I would give it up to the A32 in this category. This is an awesome display as far as I can tell. For processing on this smartphone is the MediaTek Helio G80 chipset. 6GB of RAM and 128GB of internal storage, expandable via the dedicated expansion slot. And it runs on Android 11 and One UI 3.1. Now, I have been using this smartphone for the basic task as my second phone or backup device while testing the A52 for about 2 days now. Mobile games are quite decent and playable on the smartphone, but like I mentioned, this is my first impression video and I'll give you guys my general thoughts on its performance once I switch over to it being my daily driver. It definitely isn't the fastest device there is out there, obviously. Even the in-display fingerprint sensor on the smartphone feels a little slow, but gets you up and running for security. Now for the cameras here, you get a quad camera configuration, 64 megapixel for the main rear sensor, 8 megapixel ultra wide, 5 megapixel for both the depth and the macro sensors, while on the flip side, the front-facing camera is a 20 megapixel sensor for your selfies. Now here are some photos taken with this device. They are quite usable with good contrast and under good lighting, but not the best you can get for the price in my opinion. Videos are capped at 1080p here from the smartphone. The battery is where this phone shines. You get a 5000mAh capacity on the A32, something that I haven't been able to deplete in my time of using this device as a backup device. That's been 2 days right now. One other thing you notice about the smartphone is that it has support for just 15W fast charging, and it should take you a little over 2 hours to charge it up from 0 to 100 with the 15W charger included in the box. So what are my final thoughts as someone who barely got this device 2 days ago and started using it as a backup device? I would like to say that this device is slightly overpriced, as I can see some better options out there for the money you pay for the smartphone. Would I say you shouldn't get this device right now? Well, not really. There might be some more reasons to pick up the Samsung Galaxy A32, and I'm going to test this smartphone and let you guys know in my full review. So if you want to stay and get that review on this channel, why not click on that subscribe button right now, click on the like button also to help us with the algorithm, and I'm going to catch you guys in the next one. Kawida Day.